So as part of my journey towards a low-bot year, I decided that I was going to go ahead and do a clothing inventory. And as you can see here on top of my Google Sheet, I have a total of 239 items from my inventory. And the biggest section of that or category of that is casual wear. So there's a few things in here, and I'm keeping my eye on this so that if there are anything on this inventory that I have not used for the last 6 months, or if I don't use it in the next 6 months during the changing of the seasons, then that's going to go into a pile of for donations. Okay, so this one here has got all of the subtotals at the bottom, and my t-shirts, my shirts, my tops are the largest with 40 items listed on there because there are multiples on this, but I'll get onto that as we move along. So we'll start with bags. I have 20 bags. There are 5 bags on here that I haven't even shown you guys. I had found over the Christmas period a replica of the Chanel Classic Jumbo, Classic Double Flop Jumbo on the Facebook Marketplace, and she was selling it because she hasn't been using it. So I thought, you know, I'll buy the replica, find out if it's something that I actually want to buy for real, like the real thing, the authentic one. So, and if you want me to talk a little bit more about that, because I have been using it for the last couple of weeks, let me know so that I can give you my thoughts on whether it's worth buying the authentic or not. I also found, and I know that I posted on Instagram that I would never buy the Dior book tote, because my market tote can do the exact same thing. However, I did find the leather version of that book tote with the oblique design or the Dior designs. And but I haven't actually used this. I met up with the Facebook seller at Pitt Street Mall just before New Year, the 31st. Yeah, the 31st of December. So, and I got that from her. I sold my Louis Vuitton GM Empreinte Noir bag that I got from the Kirribilli Markets. I sold that for $200, and I bought this Christian Dior oblique book tote for the same amount. So, and the Louis Vuitton was a replica. It wasn't a real thing either. So, secondhand replica. And then I also found, this would also actually say secondhand replica as well as the Chanel one. These, I've shown you the Loewe classic handbag that I got from the Kirribilli Markets before for $50, but I also got a replica of the Loewe Gate small bag and a replica of the Loewe puzzle small bag. I haven't shown you that either. Let me know if you are interested in seeing that. But these two were from the same seller from Facebook that sold me the classic double flop jumbo. She's got quite a few replicas in her collection that she hasn't been using, so she decided that she was going to let them go before the new year. So I thought I would buy it from her because I always wanted the puzzle bag, but I didn't want to pay the price for the authentic one. And since she was selling hers, I thought, yeah, I'll give it a go. Okay, so these are the 20 bags that I've kept in my collection. Me go ahead and go through the shoes. I have 25 pairs of shoes. This one here, the ASOS Wedding shoes that I use for my wedding. I haven't really used it any other time, but I just find it very difficult to let it go. So, yeah. And during my holidays in the Philippines, I went to Green Hills and bought a Chanel espadrille pair. That's obviously fake. I would have already shown you the other ones, with the exception of the Gucci loafers, which is also faux and bought at the same time that I bought the Chanel espadrilles in the Philippines. So I have, oh, and I also bought the Mondai pumps. This one is brand new and it's pure leather. It's made in the Philippines, and it's intended for use for when I go back to being an office worker, hopefully soon. 25 pairs of shoes, coats and jumpers. I have a total of 30, so 21 coats, jumpers, and vests, plus 9 scarves that I didn't identify individually anymore. I actually use the scarves to store my bags, since not all of my bags came with dust bags, so I use the scarves to protect them. There is one coat here that I haven't shown either, and it's one that I bought off of eBay. It's a Burberry jacket coat. I actually haven't received this. I purchased it just before Christmas. It was I bid on it and I won the bidding, but I asked the seller not to ship it until the 27th of December since I wouldn't be home to receive it. But because of the bushfires, the postage or the delivery has been delayed. And now it's sitting at the post office that for me to collect the next business day. Workwear is kind of limited. I've got 32 items in workwear. These include two-piece suits, so I count the pieces individually, so there's a total of 32 there for work. And then I showed you at the beginning my casual wear, which I have a shit ton of. I actually have a separate category for my denim, and this is any kind of denim, whether it's shorts, dresses, shirts, jeans, and whatnot, dungarees as well. So under denim, I've got 20 items. Dresses, I have 5. Play suits and dungarees or rompers or jumpsuits, however you want to call them. And including my vintage boiler suit there is a total of 7. Skirts, I have a total of 10, although I am thinking about letting go of this maxi skirt and the corduroy skirt since I haven't actually worn them. I will have to think about that. And then tops, I have a total of 40, as I have shown earlier. And then in shorts, I have a total of 5, like shorts that are not denim shorts. In the category of sleepwear, I have 12 items for sleepwear, a set of gray check pajamas, a set of heart pajamas, a set of red check pajamas, 3 sleep shorts, and 3 sleep shirts or tops. In activewear, I have a total of 21. This includes shorts, tops, and leggings. All of my leggings are from Under Armour because they really suck you in. And then formal wear, I have 5 items for formal wear. Here we go. And that is a total of 239 for my clothing inventory. If you are wanting me to show you the other bags that I haven't actually shown you guys, then leave them in the comment section down below. And I will tell you why I decided to buy a replica instead of authentic. But all of these replicas are bought secondhand, not from the original sellers, with the exception of the shoes that were bought from Greenhills in the Philippines, the Chanel and the Gucci ones. But the bags come from Facebook Marketplace, and they are secondhand replicas from other people here in Sydney. Okay, let me... Yeah, that's it. Now, some thoughts about creating this inventory. Well, one, it was really hard, but it was also, it was overwhelming. I almost wanted to have a panic attack, an anxiety attack, because of the amount of things that, like, realizing just how much stuff I have. So, actually, the first thing I did, there was more than 239 items, and I took a big box and put in stuff that I knew I hadn't worn for a while or would not be wearing anymore, like heels that I can't walk in. So those have been put in a box, and I've on the same day, I actually brought it to one of the Vinnies here in Sydney because I couldn't stand seeing that box full of stuff. It was just giving me anxiety. So the fact that I have these feelings over over things just tell me that I really need to whittle it down and stop purchasing anymore. In fact, knowing exactly how much stuff I have has deterred me from buying anymore. Like when I went to Vinnie's to make that donation, I would normally browse through the rails. And in fact, because it was just after New Year when I did that, there were a lot of donations that have come in. And so there's a lot of new stuff to look at, but I didn't buy any of them. I didn't even browse because I didn't want to be tempted into buying anything. So, yeah. And I think that kind of helped me, and also knowing exactly what I have in my closet when I see all of these like ads on Instagram and Facebook, and I think, oh, that looks nice, oh, it's pretty, or I want that. I then look at what I have and say, wait, I already have something very similar to that, or I already have that in my category, in my wardrobe. And that there is no gap there, so there is no need for me to purchase this. So it kind of like gave me that factual reason why I shouldn't buy anymore. So hopefully this feeling of having enough will last through the rest of the year. And as I go through the different seasons, I will review these sheets and the items in my closet, and then determine whether or not I want to keep them. And if not, then, like I said, they will go into a donation pile. Okay. I think that's it. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section down below. I'd be more than happy to help with that.